أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم آية نمبر 103 سورة البقرة ولو أنهم آمنوا واتقوا لمثوبة من عند الله خير لو كانوا يعلمون. So instead of following the black magic, if they would have adopted iman and taqwa, so that would have been much better for them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not just criticizing for nothing, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do nasiha, like well wishing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even for those people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not happy from them, Allah shafqat and Allah's kindness come in action. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, wa and law mean if. Annahum, indeed they, amanu, would have brought iman, faith. Wattaqaw, and have adopted taqwa. Taqwa, as we say, staying away from the sins, but we translate it as God-fearing. Lamasubatun, masubatun like sawab, reward. The original meaning is that sawab mean returning. Okay, returning to its original condition is called sawab. Okay, a thing go away from its original condition, it come back to its original condition, that will be called sawab. So that is why for haram, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَإِذْ جَعَلْنَا الْبَيْتَ مَسَابَةً لِلنَّاسِ وَأَمْنًا. So masaba means the place of return, that people go and they come back to their own place, like haram is like your original place. So here it means masubatun, reward. Okay? So the return of the reward toward the amal. So that is why it's called sawab. Okay, return of the reward to the action. So if the action is there, but there is no return of the reward, so that is useless, okay? Min indillahi, from Allah, khair, it would have been the better. It have been the good. Okay? Law kanu ya'lamun, if only they knew. Law kanu ya'lamun. So, for the one who like the grammar, and the one who don't like grammar, they can just ignore it. But I just say that if there is fa'il mudhari, like ya'lamu, and you add kana and fa'il mudhari, like kana ya'lamu, it gives the meaning of madhi istimrari. Like, although it is mudhari, but it gives the meaning, an action was done with dawam, with continuity in the past. So it's called kana ya'lamu. And if you add law with it, so that make it madhi istimrari shartiyya, like law kana ya'lamu. Kana ya'lamu, so you say law kana ya'lamu. It make it shart, like condition. And for every shart, you need a jaza. Like for example, you say law kana ya'lamu lakana khayran lahu. So there is jaza for it. So law kana ya'lamu, it is madhi istimrari shartiyya. And madhi istimrari shartiyya will need what? Jaza, because shart is there. But from madhi istimrari shartiyya, if you don't have any jaza, any reward, it become madhi tamannai, like you make a wish. Okay, so this is what madhi tamannai, because it is madhi istimrari shartiyya, and there is no jaza with it. So law kanu ya'lamun, then what? There is no jaza. So law kanu ya'lamun, it is like a wish, that is called madhi tamannai. لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ, if only they knew, okay? So, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا, if instead of following the black magic, they would have followed iman and taqwa, لَمَثُوبَةٌ, the reward, the ajar, مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ, with Allah khair, would have been very good. لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ, if they would know. Then the next ayah, ayah number 104, is revealed to a particular incident, and that is that whenever the Yahud used to come and see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so they will say ra'ina. Ra'ina mean in Arabic like ri'ayat. Ri'ayat mean paying, giving consideration. Like you say, make a riayat of me, which means make a consideration of me, riayat. So they will say, and ra'ina in their other language has another meaning. Not only that, but they will push the ayn, and instead of ra'ina, they will say ra'ina. Okay, which will distort the meaning, and the meaning will become like a bad one. Ra'i means shepherd. So ra'ina means our shepherd. So the meaning is bad. So instead, in the beginning they used to come and they will say ra'ina, ra'ina, ra'ina. And then they will look at one another, they will smile, they will, you know, make like a fun. So when the Yahud was saying ra'ina, so the believers also started saying ra'ina. So when the ra'ina become a problem, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, don't say ra'ina, but say unzurna. Okay, unzurna mean nazar, that look at us. Instead of saying ra'ina, stop altogether that word, because there is confusion in it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Okay, ya mean oh. And ayyuha has also meanings, but it will be explained somewhere. So, but the whole complex of the ya ayyuha, which has ya, ayyu, and ha, we translate only as o. Okay, o, like ya. Alladhina mean those. Amanu, who have iman. So, o those who have iman, la taqulu ra'ina, do not say ra'ina. Okay, ra'ina, as I told you, mean ri'ayat, consideration. وَقُولُوا and say, unzurna, look at us. Okay, so use the word unzurna instead of ra'ina. And then, wasma'u, which means, oh you who believe, what should you say? Don't say ra'ina and say unzurna, and the next thing what you need to do, wasma'u, and listen. Okay, oh believers, you should listen to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ for the disbelievers, عَذَابٌ punishment, alim. Alim is from alam, which means painful. So, يَا أَيُّوَا الَّذِينَ what is the teaching in this ayah? The teaching in this ayah is that even if something is permissible, but a person is imam, he's scholar, he's father, grandfather, and his permissible thing will also cause problem. But the permissible thing is not fard or wajib. It can be exchanged for another occasion or for another thing. So to save the people from ibham and confusion, that person should not do that thing. Okay? So like for example, the imam come and for certain reason he do something in Jummah Salat, there are 400 people, and everybody say, what the imam is doing today? He's doing it for some reason which is not known to the people. So if he cannot explain his action to all the 400 people, and everybody will be going home and making backbiting, so he should not do it. Or if he's doing it, he should tell the people, that is why I'm wearing this particular shirt today, or I'm doing this thing today. Okay? So that is the, like, what the best example of that is, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told Aisha radiallahu anha that I wish to demolish Kaaba and build it in the same way that Ibrahim alayhi salam built. Okay, Kaaba, you know Kaaba, right? So Kaaba was being built. When Kaaba was being built, so the Quraysh say, we will not use any haram money to build it. It has to be halal. So the halal money was not enough to build the whole roof. So a portion of it was short, that they had no fund. So they leave it, they leave the that portion of Kaaba outside, open. And now it is called Hatim. You see, when you go to Kaaba and there is a curve there, so they call Hatim. So the Prophet ﷺ wanted to make Hatim also part of Kaaba. So this was his wish. But the Prophet ﷺ say, oh Aisha, there are so many new Muslims in your nation now. Okay, because Islam flourished so much, and if I demolish it, suppose I hammer it so that we could rebuild it, everybody will say, oh, you are hammering Kaaba. Okay, you are demolishing it, so I will just leave it like the way it is. Okay, so that is, so although it was permissible, and the Prophet, nobody could question it, but it might cause some confusion and misunderstanding in the new Muslim mind, so the Prophet ﷺ say, okay, I will not do it. Okay, so that's the best example, that on occasion, a permissible thing, also you don't do it to save the people from the confusion. Okay? So ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you have iman, la taqulu ra'ina, do not use the word ra'ina. Waqulu, and say unzurna, use the word unzurna. And what else should you do, all the people of iman? Wasma'u, and you should listen to the instructions. Walil kafirina, and for the disbelievers, azabun, punishment, aleem, painful. Ayah number 105. ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين يود مودة ودود mean loving, liking. Okay, ودود like Abdul Wadud. The people who are disbelievers, and who are they? The people of the book and مشركين. So من is used here for bayan. Sometimes min is used for some, like some people, like minal mu'minina, from the believers there are some which are very good. So that's called min for tab'id. That from the whole majmu'a and whole collection, you separate a portion. So that min is called what? For tab'id, like ba'd. Minal mu'minina, from the believers there are some. And another meaning of the min is called min bayaniya. Min bayaniya mean that you say, رجال في المسجد. There are men in the masjid. Okay, من سليم وعلي وحبيب. So that رجال, that you say they are in the masjid, then you say, for example, who? علي, حبيب and سليم. So رجال, men in the masjid. يعني who? يعني them. So that men is used in the meaning of men, which means a word that you use before, and now you are further explaining it. So that min is called what? Min bayaniya. So that is very important. That is why I explain it, because some people, they use this min for tab'id, which is totally wrong, which means that from Ahli Kitab, there are some people who are kafir and some are not kafir. So it means the kafir people from the Ahli Kitab. So it means that there is some Ahli Kitab which is not kafir. Okay? Kafir means the one who denies the Prophet Muhammad and Quran in this, when it comes to Ahli Kitab, because they believe in Allah to some extent, right? So the disbelievers from the Ahli Kitab, which means there are non-disbelievers also, which are not. Every Ahli Kitab nowadays is what? Disbeliever. Okay? And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, مَا يَوَدُّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا will not love. Ma mean no, yawad mean love. Alladhina, those kafaru, who are disbelievers. Min yani. Min, okay? Who are those people who are disbelievers? Ahlil kitabi, the people of the book. Walal mushrikeena, and the idol worshippers, mushrikeen who do shirk, idolaters. What they don't love, the mushrikeen and the people of the book will not love. They will not like. What they will not like? أَيُنَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ, they should send down upon you, O believers, O Muslims, مِنْ خَيْرٍ, any good thing, مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, from your Lord. Okay, so this is a nuzul, revelation of the Quran. Okay, and the bi'asat of the last prophet, which is number one human being in the whole mankind, Sayyidul Khalaiq, Ashraful Khalaiq. This is such a big honor. So whenever any person who has ni'mat, so la mahala, necessarily the people will be jealous to him. Even today. Okay, anything that is something very astonishing, surprising, and a person get it, so everybody want that too. Okay, and some people will only want it, and the other will wish that you don't have it, so they will be jealous. So such a big ni'mah that you cannot imagine any bounty better than that. That the Quran is being revealed in you, and the last prophet is being sent in your tribe, so the people will not be jealous. Of course they will be jealous, particularly those bounty used to be with them, and now they are shifted and transferred toward you. So they will not be jealous. Of course they will be jealous. So Allah say, وَاللَّهُ يَخْتَصُ بِرَحْمَتِهِ, Allah choose with his mercy, مَنْ يَشَاء, whosoever who wish. So Nubuwa is what? It is wahbi. Wahbi means like Wahhab, gifted. And one is Kasbi. Kasbi mean you can earn it, earnable. Okay? Like wilayat, you want to become wali of Allah, the close friend of Allah. So it is kasbi. You can do effort to become wali. But you cannot pass any qualifying exam to become a prophet. So it is wahabi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just gift it to anybody who want. Okay? Can you become prophet? No. You, whatever you do, no matter what, you become pious for 100 years, and you don't disobey Allah with the blink of eye, even that you cannot qualify to be a prophet. Can you become wali? Wali means the close friend of Allah? Yes. If you do effort. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is wahbi, nubuwa. Wallahu yakhtassu bi rahmatihi man yasha. Allah choose for his mercy whomsoever he wish. Wallahu, and Allah zu mean possessor. Fadl mean grace and bounty. Azim mean great. Allah is the possessor of the Fadlul Azim, the great bounty. Ma yawaddu alladhina kafaru min ahli al-kitab wala al-mushrikeena. The disbelievers which are ahli kitab and mushrikeen will never love it. What? An yunazzala alaykum, that send down upon you min khayrin, any good thing min rabbikum, from your Lord. Wallahu yakhtassu bi rahmatihi man yasha, but Allah choose with his mercy whomsoever he wish. Wallahu dhul fadlil azim, and Allah is the possessor of great bounty. Right? Okay, wa akhiru da'wana.